Batteries. They're in your phone, your computer, your car. You want them smaller, cheaper, longer lasting.
When the battery goes bad, people complain. So we're trying to make better batteries so there's less complaints.
Right now, lithium-ion batteries dominate the scene. So what's next? CBSNews.com posed that question to the battery experts at Argonne National Laboratory. The answer? It's complicated.
We just don't know what lies ahead.
Here's what they do know. For the immediate future, there's still room to improve on lithium-ion technology.
There's an expectation that lithium-ion could be 2 to 3 times better than it is today.
Where do they go from there? According to the experts, a totally new way of storing energy.
We're talking about very lightweight batteries and probably designs like we haven't seen yet today.
These new designs could involve liquids or air or a hybrid of the two.
Most of the battery research field in the last 200 plus years has focused on solid state chemistry and physics. Can we, instead of solid state, store that energy in liquids?
You would be able to store the charge in a liquid that you could pump through the battery. And then once it's pumped through, you could recharge it by pumping it in the opposite direction.
This could potentially eliminate manufacturing steps, reduce the cost of the process, reduce the cost of the batteries.
Or having a battery that reacts directly with ambient atmosphere instead of reacting with lithium.
It might sound a little bit wacky right now, but we've got results that are showing us that maybe there's something there.
The experts say lithium air batteries have the potential to store up to 5 to 10 times the energy of a lithium ion battery, and the potential to be several times lighter. But it's not perfect.
There's a huge number of obstacles that stand in our way.
If you want to use oxygen as one of the components in the battery and you're taking it directly from the air, then you need to have a battery that is an open cell that can absorb oxygen from the air. And that creates a very wide host of problems.
There may, however, be stepping stones to getting there, like using a mix of air and liquid.
You know, you're using the best of both. You're storing the charge on the liquid molecules, but it's reacting also with oxygen.
There are other approaches, like magnesium-based batteries or lithium-sulfur batteries. And while they point out that there's only so many elements on the periodic table, even the experts can't predict the future. But they can spot a trend.
I can tell you with absolute certainty, batteries will be smaller, faster charging, last longer, and be less expensive, and even be safer.
For CBSNews.com, I'm Alexander Trowbridge.